Gallegato was successful in effectively pulling out most of the money.
congratulations, mate. Another great milestone, a great career for a club that you love. Not a lot of people know this, but I dabble in a bit of poetry. So I thought I'd debut my linguistic skills here for you. I call it club legend. A man full of honour and love for his club, when one speaks of Baz as setting Gosford in the pub, there's stories of pigging and fishing in there too, but it's the stories of footy that we all have more than a few. Baz has a habit of getting under the skin, but when there's a blue on, he's usually first in. His 88 calls from the guts of the scrum are almost as famous as his exploits on rum. When it comes to natural talent, Baz has just enough. He's got a heart the size of a Morungi stone, and he's pretty bloody tough. Everyone who's played with Baz would certainly call him a mate, for a better bloke you won't find anywhere in the state. The Barrett name and city have always been bound, and Baz's love for his family is the strongest around. Saturday's game's just like the 3:20 before. Instead of a couple of frothies, you'll be having a fair few more. Holding the club record sounds as good as it looks, but it won't mean shit if you don't beat them chocks. Get into them, man.
Hey, brother. Mate, so proud of you. 321 games. There's no more deserving person within the club to hold that record. I know that your family will be so proud of you. I only think back to under-12s, mate, when you scored your first try on the 5-metre line and celebrated like you just won a grand final, only for the referee to call it back and give the other team a scrum on the 5-metre. So, mate, you've come a long way. I look up to you as a person, as a friend, and also as a rugby player. Mate, go out there and rip into those chooks, just like I know that you love to do. And yeah, mate, I hope you get a little bit of meat, and I look forward to having quite a few beers with you after, mate. It's good stuff. And
all. So, mate, congratulations. 321 games, mate. That's a bloody lot of footy. Not only am I proud of you, I'm sure the whole family is, and I know Granddad's not here, mate, and I know he didn't say it very often, but he'd be bloody proud of you, mate. It's a big feat on anyone's note or in any game, never mind rugby union. Once again, mate, congratulations, and I am proud of you. Well done.
Congratulations, Baz, an absolute amazing effort. Mate, I was thrilled to share a handful of these games with you, and more than that, to sit around the table with Jim the week after and relive every single one of them and every single decision and every single referee's call that next week. Mate, well deserved that you hold this record. You know he'd be absolutely tickled pink, as are the rest of us, buddy. Good on you, mate. Enjoy the weekend. Get stuck into it.
Hey, Chris. Here's to you. 321 games. To get there, you've been the definition of dedication and determination. Both a leader on the field and off the field, the Barrett family and the Orange City family are both incredibly proud of you.
And then I can hear, it was actually quite good.
Brother, I just don't want to be yelling out too mad, that's all.
Yeah.
Christopher, when you were talking, congratulations on your club record today. It's a pretty good achievement. Well deserved. You've been through a few highs and lows.
I wish I had one that I could just sit down and...
Hope you and the team has a blinder today. Good luck.
Yeah, it's all right.
Congratulations, Baz, on the milestone. Very proud to have played with you and coached you and been a part of such a great club. Once again,
well done. Pants me.
Barrett, let's talk about pride for the jersey. Let's talk about loyalty. Baz, you need no reminding of a man. Your grandfather, Jimmy Barrett, a man who practically bled orange and green. And his love for Orange City was genetic, and it shone through all of his grandchildren, but most of all, particularly you, Bazza. He's going to be watching down from heaven this Saturday, smiling from ear to ear, probably a gold can in his hand. Can't remember a game where he wasn't down there with Paulie in tow, sucking on a gold can, watching the City boys run around. Absolutely wonderful. That's pride for the jersey, and that is loyalty. And majestic Pride Park, the hallowed turf. There wouldn't be a blade of grass out there that hasn't seen your claret, Baz, or your sweat for that matter. And how good's that? City went through those lowly moments. I remember around 2010, we were getting flogged most games, and you were always there, Baz. Through thick and thin, you were there. And that, again, pride for the jersey and loyalty to the club. Things were looking up in 2011 for Randy's men. We fell desperately short in the semi-finals. But little did we know we were going to go on a run of undefeated games in 2012 and 2013. And Baz, you were there. That family history, the unwavering loyalty, putting the club first, always shone through for you, Bazza. And you're an inspiration to us all, mate. Again, pride for the jersey and loyalty. That's what you showed me.
Ladies and gentlemen, here we are with the Orange City live stream broadcast of today's minor semi-final between Orange City Lions and the Dubbo Roos. I'm Jason Hamling, and I'll be trying to call the game here at Apex Oval in Dubbo, where we've had a fair bit of rain, but the ground has dried out, so it should be a great, fast, open game of football. We're waiting for the two sides to take the field here. The sun has come out, so it's pretty warm. We've just saw Emus go down to Bathurst in the second grade, so that means Emus are out, and Bathurst make it through to the grand final in second grade. I'll go through the teams before they run out. For the Dubbo Kangaroos, the first grade side is Andy Lehman at number one, Will Anderson at two, Edward Williams at three. The two second rows are Ronan Scott and Ben Nags. The breakaways are Connor Burke and Will Archer. The number eight is Sean McHugh, and he's the captain. The halfback is Hamish Gordon. The 5'8 is Jake Stiles. Inside, Johnny Mafiti. The outside centre is Falosi Patu. The two wingers are Tim Beach, Charlie Kempson, and the fullback is Jaden Blake. As Orange City are just about to make their way onto the field, led out by their captain, Josh Tremaine. The side is Sia Namani, Josh Tremaine and Keith Lawson. The second rows are Thomas Fenton, Alexander McNiven. The breakaways are Logan Brockman and Thomas Menensky. The number eight is Rakai Tahaki. The number nine is Thomas Snell. The 5'8 is Joe Lamborghini. The centres are Duncan Young and Keegan Harding. On the wings is Nicholas Smith and Emmanuel Rodriguez. And the fullback is Steve Witters. So City have taken to the field. We're just waiting for Dubbo to come out. Winner of this goes into the grand final next week against Emus at Wade Park after Emus defeated Bathurst yesterday in a tight one. Fairly good crowd here. And I would like to thank the sponsor of this live stream, which is Cheney Timber Transport, which you can contact Mal for all your timber needs. Give him a yell, and he can organise anything to do with timber. So we just wait for Dubbo to take the field. Coach Viv Passy down on the sideline. He's looking. Here comes Dubbo now. Dubbo just about to take the field. Led out by their captain, Sean McHugh. They've obviously got the home side support here. So it's going to be a great game of football. As I said, there was plenty of rain earlier on in the day, but the ground has dried up, so it should be a fast-flowing game of rugby. As the fans leave the ground now for this game to kick off, and the winner goes on to meet Emus in the grand final next week at Wade Park. Talking to Coach Viv Passy early, he said the boys had trained very, very well through the week. Thursday was one of the best sessions that they've had. So it should be a really good game of rugby here up in Dubbo. And, the City boys, they're here to do a job. So let's hope they can do it. And we can have a local derby game next week at Wade Park in the grand final. Teams just getting together now just to have their final last instructions. Just waiting for the kickoff. City to kick off here through Duncan Young will get us underway here at Apex Oval in Dubbo. Winner through to the grand final against Emus. Loser bows out for the year. Okay, we're set for a go. Here's the whistle. Young kicks it off. It's a short restart. Dubbo knock it back. They're starting to spread it wide now through the Dubbo backs. Oh, that's a nice hit by Rakai Tahaki there. He's rolled away. Dubbo still maintain the ball. They put it deep. Back to the full, back to Keegan Harding. He gets the ball. He's trying to get some field position. He puts it down into Dubbo's 22. Dubbo will respond with another kick, and it's not going to go out neither. So that's Keegan Harding again. He'll take that. He passes it back into Duncan Young. What's Duncan going to do? He decides to have a run. No, it comes back to Keegan Harding. He puts a little, that's a charge down by Dubbo. It's play on. Joe Lamborghini gets it. He passes it on. That goes on to Steve Witters. Oh, he just, that was very close to City going down into the corner there to score the first try. But there was a knock on there by City. So it's a Dubbo feed. Just near halfway. This ground is not wet, it's dry. So it'll suit Orange City with the expansive rugby that they play. So let's hope we can see some points scored here today. Dubbo got the feed, just 5 metres, 10 metres on their side of halfway as we wait for this scrum to be packed. Good crowd here in Dubbo. The grandstand up here is full. So, you know, there's been a... I've seen a lot of Orange people come up, so they've made the trip up here to watch this game. As the scrum forms, packs, Dubbo... Oh, Orange City have got a good scrum there. I'll tell you what, they've got a penalty. Dubbo have got... Orange City have got a penalty there on a Dubbo feed. That will give Orange City tremendous... confidence going into the game there. That was a great scrum by Orange City as Duncan Young moves up to take the kick, put it into touch, and let's see what City can do with their line out. They're just, oh, they'd be 20 metres from the goal line here. Orange City feed, just waiting for the ball. Josh Tremaine, City move into the line out. Let's see what happens. Okay, they've won it at number two. They've taken it down. They place it back. They get it out to the backs. Rakai Tahaki goes for a run there. They still retain the ball. Tom Nell. They're pushing it forward. There's a must be an advantage there. That's the back's ball. That's a great pass there. Back to Keegan Harding. Keegan Harding has been tackled. Advantage was being played by the referee there for offside, so that'll be a penalty to the right of the post for Orange City as he played advantage there for a fair while for two or three phases. So let's see what they do here. Do they take the points or do they put the ball into the corner and try and score a try? The Dubbo captain moves forward just to see what it was about. Referee explains what was going on and City will have a shot at goal here. They're on the 22, right of the post. And we'll see if Keegan Harding can slot it for Orange City's first points. It's been a good start by City, especially with that first scrum. And then they retained the ball. And then there was a penalty given for Dubbo being offside. Keegan Harding puts the ball on the tee, lines it up. This will be a fantastic confidence booster for Orange City if they can get the first points of the day here. Harding takes another look at the kick as he steps back. It's pretty quiet in the grandstand as he goes to take this kick. He lines it up. Takes one more look at it. Moves in. Oh, looks fantastic off the boot. That's a great start for Keegan Harding. A great start for Orange City. They go to a 3-0 lead here, which will give them plenty of confidence moving into the game. And again, we'd like to thank Cheney's Timber Transport for this live stream. Thanks, Mal and Beck, your kind gesture so everyone can watch this who couldn't make it to the game is fantastically appreciated. It goes to Duncan Young, and then they swing it across to Keegan Harding. It goes on to Witters. Witters makes a bit of a gap there. He's done all right. He's put the kick infield. It's gone back to Dubbo. He sets it up. He takes it up, and he's tackled on the 22, keeps it alive. Dubbo, oh, that's a lovely tackle. Let's see if City can get the ball back here. Dubbo have controlled it. They've still got it there. And then they take it through the forwards. Dubbo's still retaining possession here, just near the halfway. They've put a kick up, which is going down to Keegan Harding. He takes it nice and safely. He puts it back. It's going down to the centre of the field, which the Dubbo fullback is going to be able to... Well, it's a kicking duel at the moment, and Dubbo have put it back. Emmanuel Rodriguez gets it. He takes it up. A little chip over the top, and the ball bounces into Dubbo's hands, and they're tackled there just between halfway and the 22. Dubbo got the ball here. The halfback swings it back. Dubbo putting it through their forwards. Another kicking duel here, back to Keegan Harding. He grabs the ball. He runs it out. What's he going to do with it? Is he going to play? No, he's going to pass it on, and it goes out to Duncan Young. Play on. A lot of crowd thought that was forward. That's a beautiful kick by Duncan Young. Fantastic. Fantastic kick just on the 22 there. That'll be Dubbo's feed. Well, City are really taking it to Dubbo at the moment, and this is fantastic confidence booster for them. This is really going to set the game up for a good result here, and hopefully an Orange City victory. As Dubbo go to put the line out in, they've gone to number two. They pass it out, and then it goes out to the fly half, who then inside to a forward. That's a great tackle there by Keith Lawson, who bring that player down. Dubbo looking to clear the ball out of their 22, and he does that exactly, which is the kick goes up just to the halfway line. It'll be an Orange City feed. 3-0 here to City over the Roos, and as I said, they've started really well. They've started really positive, Orange City here, so hopefully we can continue this on. And okay, City win the ball from that line out. He takes it up. He's brought down on the ground. Tom Nell fires it back over to Joe Lamborghini, who then hands it on to Sia Namani, who takes it up. City are laying a platform here, which is good news. It goes into Duncan Young, back inside to Keegan Harding. Keegan Harding tackled there, but City seem to have retained the ball there as they bring it onto the forwards to take it up to lay another platform. Let's just see what City do here. They bring it out to Rakai Tahakia. He takes it up. He's met heavily in a strong tackle there, but able to place the ball back. Not the best of passes, but it bounces up. City are looking, containing the ball very well here. And Tom Nill makes a little darting break just up there from the ruck. They lay it back again. Let's see what they're going to do here. I think it'll be the forwards taking it up. Yes, it is. Sia Namani takes it up. The ball's laid back there. Penalty to Orange City. Penalty to Orange City. Well, this is another great spot for a kick at goal. So they are going to do that. Keegan Harding walks over and says, give me the ball, pass me the kicking tee. And this could be 6-0 to Orange City if he puts this one over the post. What a confident start by Orange City. It's been just, they've held the ball on, they're maintaining phases, which, you know, that's how you win rugby games, by keeping the ball, and City have done that. They've given Dubbo no possession. And Dubbo have tried to play field position when they've had possession, which hasn't worked for them yet. Anyway, we'll see what happens here. Keegan Harding lines it up. It's just about in the same spot where he kicked it before, so he's only got to do what he did before, and that'll give City a 6-0 lead as he lines it up, takes a look. Crowd goes silent here. He moves into it, and we'll see how we go. Oh, I think he's done it again. That's a magic kick by Keegan Harding. That was straight over the black dot. Well, Orange City 6-0. And they've come here with a job to do, Orange City, and they are doing it so far. Dubbo have been starved of possession, and City are just taking it to them here at the moment. So this is good news as Dubbo, with a restart drop kick. They've gone high and short. Let's see how we go here. That's a nice take there by Rakai Tahaki. He puts the ball back. It's gone back to Keegan Harding, and he's put his slipper to it. It hasn't gone out. It's gone back to the fullback for Dubbo. He's decided he's going to run it. They've got some players to the right. Yep, and he's passed it on. Oh, that's a missed tackle by City. That was great work by Emmanuel Rodriguez. He got the ball back. City have retained possession just near their 22. And Duncan Young, well, it's come off the side of his boot there. It's gone back to Dubbo captain Sean McHugh. He's passed it on to Charlie Kempston, and he slipped over there. Well, there's a penalty going over the top by Duncan Young. Let's see what Dubbo do here, whether they want to keep the pressure on or they want to put the kick over. Dubbo taking their time, thinking about what they're going to do here. City 6-0 so far. And there's some... No, they're going to put it in the touch. Dubbo are going to put it in the touch here, so we'll have a line out. Dubbo ball. And it's in between the 22 and the goal line here with a Dubbo feed. This will test City's line out here. Let's see how we go. They line it up. Yep, Dubbo win that pretty comfortable. City did not contest the ball. They send it out to the backs. Dubbo, they've gone wide. It goes out to Jaden Blake. He's tackled just in front of the City post here, not too far out. They go wide again, and it goes on to Will Archer. He's taken down by some strong City defence. The halfback goes through. Well, there's a knockdown by City. The advantage has gone up by the referee for Dubbo here. So he's playing advantage for Dubbo. Still got the hand out. Dubbo still moving forward. Going to have to watch it here, Orange City. They're very close, Dubbo, here. They're starting to move up the paddock. They go wide again. No, he's been held up. I think the Dubbo player's been held up there. There's two lines here, which makes it confusing, and there's lines here for soccer, which is not the try line, and it's been... Even in the second grade, a couple of players scored on that line and they were still a few metres out from the try line. So we're just going to see what's happened here. The referees, they weren't too confident, the Dubbo players. They all didn't go up, but we'll see what the touch judge and the referee say here as he comes back. No try. So what's it going to be? He's going to play the advantage and give... Well, there's a bit of confusion going on. I don't know if the ref knows what's going on here. He's given a penalty. Well, that's... I don't know. I thought he was playing advantage for over there, so I don't understand what that penalty's for. Anyway, Velosi Potota's got the ball, and they're going to put it in the touch and have a line out and see whether they can roll it in from here. This will test City's line out. They're about 6 metres out from the City line with a Dubbo feed here. Let's see how City go in defence. They go straight to two, and they're coming around the blind there. Well, that's a good move by Dubbo. There was three or four of them coming around the front. They've just scored in the corner. So that'll make it 6-5 kick to come to Dubbo. Roll it in from here. I'll bring it out to the 22. I didn't quite catch what that last penalty was for, but that's okay. That takes it to 6-5, kick to come, and it's a difficult kick for the Dubbo goal kicker. as he lines it up. This to make it 7-5 to the Roos. He moves into it. It's just gone to the right of the post, so he's missed that. That'll make it 6-5 to City still. City to kick off. Duncan Young brings up. The sun's out here. It's a beautiful afternoon for rugby here. Okay, Duncan Young gets the restart underway. Dubbo catch it just near their 22. He's knocked it back, says the referee. And the Dubbo have put it deep back to Witters, who has the ball. What's he going to do with it? He passes it on to Keegan Harding. Keegan Harding looking for a kick there. Dubbo put it back. Joe Lamborghini's there. He'll pick it up. And here he goes for a run. Now, this will be exciting if he gets away. He's got some players in support here. I'll tell you what, Orange City, if they spread it wide. Oh, I think Duncan could have given that. This is good play by Orange City. They're keeping the ball. Oh, there's a penalty to Orange City. Well, the referees called the whistle here. So City will hand the ball on to Keegan Harding again to have a shot at goal and take the score out to 9-5, hopefully. This is probably one of the easiest kicks he's had today. So let's see if he can put it over. And again, we thank our live stream sponsor, Cheney's Timber Transport. Contact Mal and Beck for all your timber needs. They can sort anything out to do with timber, Mal and Beck. So yeah, get in contact with them if you need anything. Patios, fences, anything to do with timber, give Mal and Beck a call. Keegan Harding lines it up. Has a look, goes through his routine. This will take the score out to 9-5 to City. They've kicked three penalties if he gets this one over. He's lined it up. And he hasn't missed one. He hasn't missed one today, so that's great news for City. He's got his kicking boots on, so 9-5. Both teams are trying to do field possession. They're both kicking a lot, just trying to get that advantage with field possession. And Joe Lamborghini's run up the middle there looked very exciting, so that's something that we may be able to look forward to coming up. That's a fantastic restart by Dubbo, and they've retained possession. Their captain, Sean McHugh, got the ball back. So here's Dubbo on a bit of a roll here. It's gone out to the hooker there for Dubbo, Will Anderson. He's brought down the halfback, the Sean. Oh, there's a knock on. City will come up with that one. And he'll play a bit of advantage here. So Joe Lamborghini gets it. Oh, that's good hands. He's played on. Emmanuel Rodriguez stepping around. City taking it up the middle through their forwards. They retain possession. Tom Nell back to Joe Lamborghini. He passes it on to Logan Brockman. What's he going to do? He's going to take the tackle. That's what he's going to do. And City retain possession. Tom Nell passes it on. It goes wide to Duncan Young. That's a massive pass. City are going for a bit of a run here. I'll tell you what, that's a great run by Thomas McKenzie. He set the ball up strongly there for City. They retain possession here, City. They're just near the 22. As they punch it up through the forwards. Let's see what we can do here. Goes forwards taking it forward again. They're retaining possession. Tom Nell then on to Josh Tremaine. That's a good strong run by the hooker. Tom Nell again on to Joe Lamborghini. What's he going to do? He's going to go. He's still stepping. He's going around them. He passes it on. I'll tell you what, this could be a try. Oh, he's just gone into touch. Just gone into touch. Geez, that was close to Nicholas Smith. Just got him on that final tackle to put his legs in the touch. That was well done by Orange City, keeping the possession, just rolling it down the field. Great work. Dubbo line out, it's about 7 metres out from the Dubbo try line. They feed it in. And Dubbo take possession there. I'm sure they'll clear it. No, they've gone for a run there. And City, they've retained possession. So it'll be a clearing kicky by Dubbo, which I don't think's found touch. So Widders should be at. They're offside, Orange City. So the referee's given the penalty. Just near the 22 there for Dubbo. And they will have a penalty to get out of there. Red zone. 9-5 here to City so far, and we're probably 25 minutes into the game as Dubbo find touch. Well, the ball's actually been kicked on the roof, so that was a fairly big kick by the Dubbo player there. Let's see what we can do here. Dubbo about 15 metres out from halfway on their side. Dubbo feed the ball. They win the line out pretty comfortably. It goes back. They bring it out to the centre of the field where the forwards are setting up the play. And then they'll bring it back to the right as they... That's good defence by Orange City. That's Logan Brockman. He's having a wow of a game, Logan Brockman. He's been very hard in defence. Oh, there's a knockback. What's going to happen here? City towered forward. I'll tell you what. Well, that's very close. And that'll be a 5 metre scrum to Orange City. Well, that was a shocking mistake by the Dubbo player there. He completely knocked that back. Let's see what Orange City can do. If we go on their first scrum, they're fairly strong in the scrum here, City. Let's see if we can push Dubbo back maybe or out to the backs. We'll see what they've got installed anyway. As they pack the scrum, 5 metres out in the centre of the field. Scrum set. Down they go. Nah, referee doesn't like it. He'll have it again. City's got a monstrous pack when you have a look at them. And they've got some fairly handy reserves sitting down here on the bench too. So, you know, that's City got some pretty big forwards, which is fantastic, and they complement the backs very well. So here we go again. See if the referee lets it pack this time. And in we go. That's a better scrum there by Dubbo. Has a move. So it's quick ball out to Orange City. It goes round. He's caught with the ball there, Joe Lamborghini. But City hold possession as they go in. Rako Tahaki takes it up. He's gone forward. He retains possession as well. Oh, Tremaine met with a strong defence there, but he's able to lay it back. Quick ball out to the right-hand side. The City just trying to edge their way forward as they move it round. As Thomas Fenton takes it up, goes to Nell, goes wide. Keegan Harding caught there. He needs to hit the deck, which he does. City still retaining possession here as Fenton takes it up again for another settler. They're just seeing whether they've got numbers. I'll tell you what, he's hitting spin. Oh, he's very close. Tom Nell. What's going... Play on, says the referee. I'll tell you what. Caught in heavy defence. That was very close for Orange City as Logan Brockman takes it up just to settle things down and reset for Orange City. They're about five out from Dubbo's try line here. Goes to Joe Lamborghini. He steps off his other foot. He's caught well by Dubbo. There's the ball. It goes wide. Keegan Harding on the Rakai Tahaki. He flicks it up. Oh, it's gone forward. That was good defence by Dubbo. The City were pressing their try line, but just couldn't get over. But the ball came forward there by Rakai Tahaki, and that was very close close call for Dubbo there, and City were just pounding their line and just couldn't break. They nearly went in there at one stage, but it was very close, but wasn't to be. So let's see what City can do with this scrum. Wouldn't be long to go. 9-5 is the score here to City. Wouldn't be long before halftime. Let's say pack the scrum down. Let's see what City can do with this. Nah, the referee doesn't like that. He's going to reset that scrum. So he just has a talk to the front row about what he wants as they reset again. 9-5 here to City. It's got a bit dark now. The sun's gone away and I don't think there'll be any more rain, but as I said, there was plenty of rain here this morning, and this ground here in Dubbo is drained beautifully, so we've got a great surface for some rugby. Nah, referee doesn't like that one again. I'd say he won't give too many more chances here. Someone will be penalised if they can't get this scrum packed. Here at Apex Oval in Dubbo, where there's a number of Orange City fans that have made the trek up. So they're hoping to go away for victory here, which would put them into a grand final with Emus at Wade Park next Saturday. A local derby grand final, which, you know, would be fantastic. As they pack the scrum, this time the scrum's right to go. Ball goes in. Dubbo scrum holds strong. Oh, that looked forward, that pass. Yeah, that is a forward pass. That'll give City a scrum 5 out from the Dubbo line. Let's see what City can do here. This is a really good chance for Orange City to put a try on just before half-time. They've had all the possession down here. They need to go away with some points here, Orange City, as they lead the Dubbo Roos 9-5. Scrum gets set. No, it's a differential. Well, that's just a waste of possession there for Orange City. I don't know what happened there, but the ref's given a differential penalty to Dubbo there. Well, that's just not good. 5 out from the line with a feed as Dubbo takes the tap and spreads it wide. Witters just going to let the ball dribble into halfway. It's probably good he didn't play at it, because the ball had a lot of momentum going towards that touchline. Well, the City have gone from a 5-metre scrum to their feet to up on halfway, which, you know, you've got to take these opportunities when they come. You can't give away silly penalties like that. As City, Josh Tremaine goes to feed the line out. It's gone over, but play on, says the referee. Went over the back. City maintained possession. And that's a Dubbo penalty just on halfway. Which I'm sure they'll put into touch. 9-5 still to Orange City over Dubbo. As he just puts it into touch, and they'll have a line out between the halfway and the 22 with a Dubbo feed. Will Anderson gets ready to throw the ball in for Dubbo. It goes in. Dubbo come up with it. That's play on. As here goes Dubbo on the attack. Gordon puts it on to Connor Burke, who just sets it. Will Archer takes it up. There's a run round. I'll tell you what, there's some room here to move. And City bring him down about 10 metres out from the City try line. The hooker there takes it up. Will Anderson, he's met some strong defence. City have got to keep their defensive line here. Goes out to Dubbo. They've play on. The ball came spewing out there. Oh, Knockback, says the... it's a knock-on by Dubbo. Well, that was lucky for Orange City because Dubbo looked like they were on the attack there. So there'll be a scrum just in front of the Orange City post between the 22 and the goal line City feed. And we wouldn't have long till half-time, I wouldn't think. 10 minutes. Toby, the cameraman, just tells me. So that's not long to go. City to feed the scrum just in front of the post here between the 22 and the goal line. Nah, referee not happy with that again. There's some issues going on in the scrum there. I'm sure Josh Tremaine's in the middle of there. He's very experienced hooker there. He's played with this club. He had a couple of seasons with Dubbo and now he's back with Orange City and continuing on his stellar career. As they resit again, let's see what whether the referee will let this one set. Tom Nell looking round. They let it pack now, that's better. Tom Nell puts it in. That's a strong scrum there by City. Keegan Harding looking for a clearing kick and it goes down to Jaden Blake. He's going to run it by the look of this. He's running it up. Nice tackle there. City trying to line up there. Yeah, good tackle, Keegan Harding. Dubbo keeping possession here. They're just... Oh, Dubbo's... Oh, there's a knock-on again by Dubbo. This is great news for Orange City. They'll have a scrum just near the halfway, just over City side of halfway, with the score still remaining at City 9 and the Roos 5. Not long till halftime here at Apex Oval in Dubbo. Been a few issues here in the scrums for the referees. Been pulling a lot of them up, as you know. City had a 5 metre scrum and gave away a differential penalty, but now it's their scrum just near the halfway, just on City side of halfway. Tom Nell puts it in. Rock solid, the Orange City scrum. It goes over to Jay Lamborghini. He's caught just near the touchline as City lay the ball back. Rakai Tahaki takes it up. They retain possession. Tom Nell gets it out. Goes out to Thomas McKenzie, who sets it up just over the halfway. Then that's knocked back. They've retained possession. Keegan Harding tackled there. They still retain possession. That's a penalty going in the side there from Dubbo. Didn't come through the back, went into the side there by Falonsi Patua, who should probably know better than that. City get the penalty just near halfway. Duncan Young puts it down into the Dubbo. The Dubbo 22. Orange City to feed. Josh Tremaine walks up. It's a tight game here, 9-5. It's a bit of an arm wrestle between the two sides. City have had a lot of possession as they win that line out. Play on, says the referee. Passes it out. Jay Lamborghini decides to go for a run. He gets through. Oh, I tell you what, that's a great run. He lays it back. What's City going to do here? They play it wide as it goes to Witters. Witters runs it. He puts a little grubber in. I tell you what, there could be a try. They're claiming a try. The referee... He's going to He's going over to talk to his touchdown. City are claiming a try by
as he
passes it out. Joe Lamborghini decides to go for a run.
Put in the back
he
there
gets
by
through. Oh, I'll tell you what, that's a great
a
run.
There and
he lays it back. What's City going to do here? They play it wide.
Widders
as it goes to Widders.
Widders
runs it. He puts a little grubber in.
Let's see if there's any hand on the ball. I couldn't quite see there. The City claim it.
That's a try. City have scored in the corner. What a fantastic try by Rodriguez, and Widders with a fantastic little kick behind the back line there of Dubbo. And Rodriguez scooted through. I thought for all money that Dubbo were able to put that dead. But and City have taken the scoreline out to 14-5 just before half time. And we'd like to thank all the Orange City sponsors. Obviously, without sponsors, you don't have a rugby club, and Orange City have a number of sponsors who we are greatly appreciated throughout the club, and we'd like to thank them. As City, Keegan Harding lines up, this is his hardest kick of the day. He's got 3 from 3 so far, and this one's over on the touchline as he lines it up. This to make it 16-5 just before half time. As he moves into it. Nah, he didn't like it off the boot. That's been flagged away. 14-5 City over the Roos. After a beautiful try in the corner by Emmanuel Rodriguez. And once again, we must thank Mal and Beck Cheney for their great sponsorship of this live stream of this game as Dubbo restart. It's a high one. Oh, it's gone taken through by Connor Blake, who caught it off the Connor Burke, who took it off the kickoff. City being told to get onside here. He's straight on the attack, Dubbo. That's a great bit of defence there by Orange City as he moves away from it. So it's Dubbo on the attack here. They've got a reserve on number 19. Don't know his name, and they retain possession. They're coming wide here. Oh, that's a great ball. Let's see what happens here. That's Dubbo just near the try line. What are they going to do here, Dubbo? As they go for a try, he's gone over the top. Ah, the Dubbo referee. The referee's, it's been held up. Well, that was a near thing for Orange City. Very close for Orange City. It's great defence there by Orange. They were right near their line, peppering their line, and City were able to hold them out. Let's see whether City can hold them out now.
He's
gone over the top.
It's a 5 metre scrum to Dubbo.
Nah, the Dubbo referee, the referee's, it's been held up. Well, that was a near thing. As Dubbo bring on a reserve. As they set here, this will be an interesting scrum for Orange City. This will be a tester. The scrums have been rock solid so far. Let's see what City can do here. As City, oh, it was close to a knock on by Dubbo, and that was a, oh, there's a penalty there. Oh, hang on. Referee is blowing his whistle. And he's gonna bring, he's calling the captain out, Josh Tremaine, and I'm sure Duncan Young will be called out and spoken to. He's speaking to Josh Tremaine to tell his players just to release the ball, and that's what Josh does. So penalty to Dubbo here, not long before half time. Let's see what they do. What are they going to do, Dubbo? 14-5 to City, they're going to have a shot at goal. I thought Dubbo might have kept the pressure on there, but they've decided to take the kick as the sun peeks its way through the clouds again here at Apex Oval.
not long before half time, 14-5 to Dubbo. No, 14-5 to City, sorry. And this will make it 14-8 if he kicks this over. Hamish Gordon lines it up. Moves into it. Nah, ball's fallen off the tee. City reserves just going for a bit of a jog up the field. Keen to get on. As Hamish Gordon lines it up, he moves into it. And he's kicked it. So that'll make it 14-8. And that's halftime here at Dubbo Apex Oval. City leading 14-8. And this has been a great game of rugby union. It's been a real arm wrestle. And we'll see you back after the halftime break.
Tastes like strawberries on a summer evening, and it sounds just like a song. I want more berries and that summer feeling. It's so wonderful and warm. Breathe me in, breathe me out. I don't.
Lamborghini takes it up again. Welcome back here to Dubbo, where City have retained possession off the kickoff as Duncan Young goes deep into Dubbo, just looking for some field possession. Dubbo deciding to run the ball here as the winger Charlie Kempston tackled. City have got some field position there. As, oh, there's a knock on by Dubbo. Geez, their handling's been terrible today. Dubbo, they've dropped a lot of ball. It's gone behind them. The passing from the rucks and the mauls have been behind him. So this is a great opportunity for City just after half time here at Apex Oval, where they held a 14-8 lead. The Dubbo Googars used to play here at Apex Oval back in the day, and they used to run around here on this oval. Now it's just a fantastic facility, as there's a bit of movement on the bench here for both teams as City pack a scrum 10 metres into Dubbo's territory. Scrums have been rock solid today as Tom Nell puts it in. City maintain it. It goes out to Joe Lamborghini. Here's the Dubbo, the City backs. Let's see what they can do. Duncan Young takes it forward. City hold possession. Tom Nell goes on to Thomas Fenton, who holds the ball. Siya Namari takes it up. He holds possession. City then still got possession. A City still holding possession. Tom Nell goes in there. Goes wide. That's Witters. What's he going to do with it? He goes, he's made a little gap here. Witters, has he got any support? He's ran away from his support and he's tackled there. That's a great run by, but he's having an absolute blinder of a game. It goes out the Lamborghini. They've got numbers here, Orange City. Keegan Harding back inside to the winger. Oh, he's nearly there. He's just been bundled in the touch. That's so close for Orange City. That was great work by Witters, who's he's made a little gap here. Witters, has he got any support? He's ran away from his support and he's tackled there. That's a great run by, but he's having an absolute blinder of a game. It goes out the Lamborghini. They've got numbers here, Orange City. Keegan Harding back inside to the winger.
Nearly, that was a great tackle by Dubbo and cover there.
He's just been bundled in the touch. That's so close for Orange City.
But he was bundled in the touch.
That was great work.
So it'll be a Dubbo feed about 3 metres out. We've got an injury here to, looks like Logan Brockman, but he's all right as he moves over for the line out. City need to steal a line out here. A try here would really make things interesting as Dubbo move in to feed the line out. Will Anderson set. As Dubbo retain possession there. City are pushing them back, but as it's not going anywhere. They roll it up the field, Dubbo, just trying to make as many yards as they can as they move it back. Dubbo going for a run here. That's their inside centre. It's in the middle of the field. It's been caught up. City, Dubbo pass it back for the clearing kick, which is not the best clearing kick that I've seen. Keegan Harding gets it, moves it back onto Witters just near the halfway. He runs. He puts a grubber through, which is probably, if it stays in the in goal, it'll be a 22 restart to Dubbo. Witters having a good game here as Dubbo set up for the 22. And they decide to go deep. Keegan Harding retains possession. What's he going to do here? He gives it out to Witters. City stretch it forward. And there's a penalty for City for going over the top. So they had possession and now they've lost it. And Dubbo get a penalty just near the halfway line. About 5 metres their side of the halfway line.
as they put it in the touch. It'll be a Dubbo feed. 10 metres into City's territory as the hooker, Will Anderson, gets ready to feed the ball. Dubbo retain possession. It goes out to Gordon and then on to Styles, who takes it up and sets it up for Dubbo. Gordon again. Back on to Williams, who takes up. Good defence there by Orange City. They haven't moved much forward yet, Dubbo. As they take it forward, Dubbo just trying to control it here, just setting some as they give it out to the back line. And that's got to be over the top. No, it's play on. I thought that was diving over the top by Dubbo, but obviously Dubbo still retaining possession, just edging forward. Oh, that's a nice ball. That's a great tackle. And City just meeting him at the defensive line, which is frustrating Dubbo, and they've just lost the ball, and it's a penalty to Orange City. Well, great work there by Orange City. They were just muscling up in defence, meeting him at the advantage line, and Dubbo now getting frustrated, throwing the ball away. Great work by Orange City as the captain has brought out the Orange City captain, Josh Tremaine, talking to the referee again. I didn't see what happened there, but just telling him, telling his teammates just to quieten down a bit and just play footy. So it'll still be a Orange City penalty. And they'll look for Duncan Young to put it in the touch. Yeah, Dubbo's been very sloppy. There's been a lot of ball which hasn't found the mark, which has just led straight in the Orange City hands at the moment. So Orange City with a line out at about 12 metres in Dubbo's side of the ground as Josh Tremaine gets ready to set the feed it, and they win it at number two, and there was a knock on there and the touch judges picked that up. They don't want to be doing too many mistakes, Dubbo, Orange City here. They don't want to let Dubbo back into this game. As they go to set the scrum, it's been a couple of easy possessions that have... Oh, there's an injury here to Rake Tahaki. As he... Referee ordering the John Gander off the sideline there, and the Dubbo just trying to get some water. The sun's come out here. It's just been an arm wrestle. You would have thought they were allowed to have water come on, but obviously not. Touch judge talking to all the water boys as they get set for this scrum. About 12 metres into Dubbo's side of halfway. There's the scrum. Oh, wow, there's a full... that wasn't on the mark, so Dubbo will take it back. As there is, as there a reserve coming on, second rower. As there's been a replacement coming on. As looks like Alexander McNiven coming off for Orange City, who's had a whale of game in the defensive. As Dubbo win the ball of the line, they spread it wide. It goes to Johnny Mafidi, centre field. Dubbo's bring it back the other way. It goes onto the hooker, Will Anderson, who's met heavily. It's back again, goes onto their captain, Sean McHugh, who passes it on to Jaden Blake, who's away. And that's good defence there by Witters. Dubbo on the attack here. They've gone wide. And that's a penalty. I didn't think that was deliberate. I thought that was all part of the tackle, but obviously the referee has seen it differently. I thought it was part of the tackling motion. The referee again calling out Josh Tremaine to have a chat to him.
Goes in.
It goes onto the hook of Will Anderson, who's met Josh will be getting sick of going up again. Goes onto their captain, Sean McHugh, who passes it on to Jaden Blake, who's away. And that's good defence there by Witters. And Dubbo on the attack here. They've gone wide.
He's been given a yellow card.
And that's a penalty.
That's going to make it for harder for City. That was
Keith Lawson. I didn't think that was deliberate personally, but referee obviously seen different. Was Dubbo taking the advantage straight away by going straight for a scrum? As Dubbo bring on replacements. Well, this is going to make it awfully hard with a man down. Let's see what happens here for Orange City. They're about Dubbo 5 out as they still lead 14-8 Orange City. As Dubbo get the feed. A man down in the scrum here, Orange City. They're holding it pretty well so far. Oh, it's just moved. Oh, that's great scrum by Orange City as the Dubbo backs go into motion. Oh, that's a great ball by the 5-8. Jake Stiles, an inside ball. That was just the numbers as the winger came through there and scored the try, which will take it up to 14-13. That inside ball by the Dubbo 5-8 and Dubbo score. Well, it's under the post. That was just the numbers. And here we go through the replay. As the winger came through there and scored the try, which will take it up to 14-13. And that'll make it 14-13. And City had one put into the sin bin, which brought the number one number down, and Dubbo will convert. So that'll take the score to 15-14 to Dubbo, and they've got one in the sin bin. So it'll be a arm wrestle of a finish here as City do the restart. Duncan Young puts it high and deep. McHugh gets it and gets tackled there. Dubbo retain possession. There's a knock on there by Dubbo. Knock on there by Dubbo.
When there's a try,
and City with the scrum feed right on Dubbo's 22. Score 15-14 to City. City with one man in the sin bin. Let's see what they can do. Referee happy with that scrum. Goes in. City retain possession. It's a good scrum by City. Knock back, says the referee. As Lamborghini picks it up. Takes the ball. They just need the reset now, Orange City, as it goes to Rodriguez. He sees a gap and spreads through. He gives it out to Witters, who's had a blinder of a game, I think, this afternoon. He's tackled. They retain possession, Orange City. They go wide. Taken up by Thomas Fenton. Oh, they've lost possession here, Orange City, I think. Nah. There was a knock-on again, I think, there by Dubbo. And City will have another scrum as he blows time off. And he's called out Josh Tremaine and McHugh again, the two captains.
Let's see what he's got to say. I think he's telling both players to keep off the ball on the ground and let the ball flow. 15-14 to the Roos here. City still a man in the sin bin. As it starts to get dark here again, it's a City feed. It's a tight arm wrestle here. It's a grind of a game, which looks like it suits both teams. And City will have possession here, just near the 22, Dubbo's side of halfway, as they get their scrum set. Winner to go on and play Emus in the grand final at Wade Park next Saturday. City maintain possession from the scrum. It goes out the Lamborghini. He goes wide. That's a good part. I'll tell you what, City have got a bit of a chance here. And he's been bundled in the touch, Witters. Didn't have much room to work with. And there's a player down for Orange City. As a player down for Orange City, I'm just trying to see who that is. Down hurt. I think he copped a hit there after he'd passed the ball. I think he's winded, so the medics are attending to him. As the scoreline is still Roos 15, City 14. Once again, we thank our live stream sponsor, Cheney, Timber, and all the other sponsors of Orange City. Without sponsors, you don't have clubs, and we thank them very much, and we ask all Orange City people who can go and use those businesses when they can. It's much appreciated. As it was Keegan Harding who... Well, they're replacing him. That's not a very good sign, because that's the goal kicker for Orange City. As he walks off, I think he's caught one in the ribs. So he'll come off. Back to the action now as City have a line out in Dubbo's side of halfway, at probably about 15 metres out from the Dubbo try line. Yeah, quick ball back from Dubbo. Here they go. They're running it now. Oh, there's a high tackle by Duncan, by Captain Josh Tremaine. It's play on. And he was onside, said the Dubbo on the attack now. It goes back to Witters. What's he going to do with it? He's going to go for a run. He steps. He doesn't want to get caught with the ball. He's away from that tackle. He plays on. Goes on to the winger. He's tackled. City need to maintain possession here, just near the halfway line, as they do, and it goes City forwards taking it into the middle of the paddock as Tom Nell passes it on to Lamborghini. He goes back to the blind side. He goes for a run. He's still going, Lamborghini. That's a great run by the 5-8. They set the ball up. Nell passes it wide. What's City going to do here? And I'll tell you what, they've got some numbers here, Orange City, but they've gone back inside. And he's being tackled just over Dubbo's 22. As Nell fires it wide, it goes to Lamborghini. Then it goes wide to Brockman. Brockman goes inside. They don't want to get isolated with the ball here, Orange City. And there's a penalty. Penalty to Orange City. This could be one in the bin for Dubbo. And it is. See you later. That's the winger gone for Dubbo. Tim Beach, go and have a rest, my friend. You're not allowed to do that. As the time would be very close for Orange City bringing back on their player. As Dubbo get the penalty, Orange City get the penalty just on the 22. What are they going to do? What are they going to do? They're going to take the shot. It shouldn't be too long before Orange City's
Keith Lawson is back on the paddock. So they're down to 14 numbers, 14 each, the numbers. So this is a pretty important kick here for Duncan Young, the usual goal kicker. Harding was taken off, and Duncan Young takes over the kicking duties. This could take the score to City 17, Dubbo 15 as Young lines it up. He moves into it. And he's kicked it. That's a fantastic kick as well. That's Orange City taking the lead there, 17 to 15. Both sides with 14 players on the field after two being in the sin bin for Orange City. And Orange City's player would be due to come back on very soon. As Dubbo with the restart. They go high and long. Orange City retain it back. And City, they're running it. Rodriguez, what's he going to do? There he goes. Back inside. That's a knock on by Orange City, trying to play expansive football. As City have got their full complement back on the field. Now City are playing with 15 men and Dubbo playing with 14. As they've taken the lead here, 17-15. And remember, the winner goes on to play Orange Emus in the grand final at Wade Park next Saturday. Scrum set, Dubbo playing full complement of forwards. City, they move into it, they feed the scrum. Referee doesn't, it's wheeled 90 degrees. Be another feed for Dubbo. This will just edge out the time. As City edging forward. As Orange City as Orange City call the traditional call of 88, as Dubbo have the feed. Just the other side of the halfway line in City's side of the field. Scrum set. They put it in. Hasn't moved. Has not moved. As Dubbo puts it out to the backs. Here they go. They take it onto the outside centre. They go wide. Goes out to the reserve. Let's see. Oh, that's a palm him off. Let's see if they can get him. Well, that was a lucky tackle there by Orange City. Oh, there's a penalty. Oh, no. As the ball came out, Duncan Young went forward. And Dubbo get a penalty. As Josh Tremaine reserved.
Pulled out by the referee.
Let's see. Oh, that's a palm him off.
Well, Josh is
let's
getting
see if they can get him.
Fairly well, because he's been
pulled out
every 10 minutes.
Well, that was a lucky tackle there
to have
by
a chat.
Orange
there's
City.
The replay. The ball
oh,
came
there's a
out.
Penalty.
Duncan Young went through.
Oh, no.
Obviously,
as the ball
a
came.
A bit too quick.
So what will they do here, Dubbo? Will they keep on the attack? McHugh asking the referee. They've called for a scrum. 88 called by City again. City need to hold it. They need to hold their line here, the defensive line. As the reserves coming on, as Logan Brockman, who's had a whale of a game in defence, comes from the field. This is a very important stage of the game here. 5 metre scrum to Dubbo. Let's see what happens here. City need to hold their defensive line. They need to hold the scrum. Scrum packs. Referee calls it in.
Scrum not going anywhere. Dubbo spread it wide. And they go very wide. Oh, great tackle by Witters. Oh, there's a knock on by Dubbo. Well, that's great defence by Witters. He's had a whale of a game. His attack's been on the mark. His defence has been on the mark. Great work by Iron City to hold Dubbo out there. Scrum not going anywhere.
17 to 15 the score
Dubbo
here.
It's very tight. The winner. And they go very well. Going on. Oh, great tackle by Witters.
To play Emus next week in the local derby at Wade Park.
Oh, there's a knock on by Dubbo. Well, scrum sets. Orange City feed. Scrum sets. Let's see what happens here. Yeah, good scrum, Orange City. They get it out. They're going to have a run with it now. He goes for a run. He goes for a bit of a gallop. They play it back. Rakai Tahaki takes it up. Sets, lays the platform back. Duncan Young with a clearing kick. And that's not a bad-looking kick. Needs to go into touch. And that it does. That's a fantastic kick by Duncan Young, which takes it up to the halfway line. Dubbo feed. 17-15 City. Some of the forwards starting to look a bit tired. It's been a arm wrestle of a game. Both sides not willing to give an inch here. Dubbo with the line out feed just on halfway. They set. They go to number two. It's passed back. Goes to the half back out to the backs. They take it forward. That's great defence by Josh Tremaine. Dubbo retain possession just near the halfway line. They go back to the blind. Dubbo. They go wide. They need to hold their composure. And there's a penalty. Penalty to Orange City for holding onto the ball. Well, if you're going to get a penalty, now's the time to get it. As Duncan Young comes over to put it into touch. As the Dubbo winger gets ready to return onto the field to make it 15 on 15. As he's warming up on the sideline, Tim Beach. He'll be eager to get on there. City win the line out. They go forward, taking it up the centre, retaining possession. Lamborghini inside the Sia Namani, who takes it up. Ball laid back beautifully. Goes to Lamborghini, and there's a nice little chip over the top. They need the bounce of the ball here. Oh, I'll tell you what, they nearly bounced into the Dubbo. Oh, good defence. It's on. As Dubbo taking it up. Oh, he's met with a wall of defence there. As they put it. Is that gone? That's gone out. As Dubbo. City will have the feed just on halfway. It's now or never for both teams. No one wants to make a mistake. As City have maintained possession there. No, Dubbo have stolen it off. And there's a penalty to Dubbo. Penalty to Orange City, I'm sorry. And here we go, he's called him out. The second rower. Ronan Scott, and he's gone. He's been sin-binned. Professional foul. As he talks to the captain. As Duncan Young comes in, it's 15 on 13. And it won't be long until it's 15 on 14. As City will have the line out.
Yeah, as the winger comes on to make it 15-14. City retain possession. Joe Lamborghini on the ruck, Otahara. He's going to hit it up the middle. That's a good run. They've got to retain possession here, Orange City, just outside the 22 in Dubbo. Nell, Lamborghini, what's he going to do? Duncan Young, he goes, he's going forward. Oh, he's met in a strong tackle. Dubbo have got possession back, which Orange City probably didn't need to happen. And now Dubbo rucking it out of just out past their 22. City didn't retain possession there. Oh, as Dubbo nearly knocked that on, but they've retained it. As they bring it back, Dubbo to clear the kick out of their 22. And it's a strong kick back to Witters. What's he going to do here? Witters takes it up. He's going to come back this way. He's going to bring them inside. He brings Rodriguez back in. Lamborghini, here he goes. He's going to go for a run. He's brought down just over Dubbo's side of halfway. City need to retain possession here. They need to keep the ball. They don't want to give the ball away. As they take it up the middle. Oh, that's strong tackle. Strong tackle. Dubbo edging forward in the defence. It goes to Lamborghini. What's he going to do? Witters. It goes back to Tremaine. Tremaine takes the ball up. He's tackled just over Dubbo's side of the halfway. As they punch forward against City. Here's where they're good at. They're just good at laying this platform. It's knocked back, says the referee. City need to get there. They need to hold this possession. Oh, there's a penalty to Dubbo. Penalty to Dubbo. 15 on 14. Still City 17. The Roos 15. Not long to go now. What are they going to do, Dubbo? They're going to put it in the touch. That's Filosone, Partu, finds touch, just on the City 22. Dubbo feed, this is, wow, this is an important part of the game here. As Sia Namani comes from the field after a strong game, as Dubbo gets set to take the line out. Dubbo retain possession. They get it straight out to the backs. They're one man down. This is going to be a crucial part for Orange City. City, as they go wide, City, oh, there's a high shot there. That's advantage to Orange City here. Advantage to Dubbo, I mean, as there's a player down, and that's a penalty. It's a high tackle, as I'm sure Dubbo will take the points here, which will make it a one-point ball game. Dubbo still down to 14 players. And there's about 5 minutes to go. Well, it's been a arm wrestle of a battle, this one. It's been a great battle here between two traditionally strong clubs in the Central West competition. Winner goes on to play Emus, who have had a flying season this year. They've won, they've been undefeated, and they'll be in the grand final next Saturday at Wade Park. Winner to meet them there. And if you want to talk about an important kick, well, the halfback here for Dubbo, Hamish Gordon, has got one on his shoulders. It's not a hard kick, but it's a pressure kick. And we'll see if he can slot it over. And that will give the lead to Dubbo 18-17 with about 5 minutes to go. He moves into it. Oh, it's hit the post and gone over. Well, that was lucky. Hit the post, went over to the side, and then bounced over the upright. So that'll be an 18-17 lead to the Roos with about 4.5 minutes to go. And this will be an exciting finish. Dubbo got 14 players on, City with 15. As Duncan Young gets the game started again, Sean McHugh takes it. That's a good tackle there.
Dubbo looking to retain possession just near their 22. And they do that. They roll it up the forwards. City need to get possession. Dubbo puts it out. It goes back to Witters. Witters, what's he going to do with it? Witters goes for a run. He's going to go for a run himself. City maintain possession. Nell gives it to Lamborghini. What's he going to do? He puts it forward. As the winger chases, where's it going to go? City. That's a great run by the Dubbo. Oh, Dubbo with some numbers here on the right-hand side. Dubbo with numbers, they're throwing the ball around. The 11 gets it. He's got through some tackles here. Dubbo get it here. The number 8, Sean McHugh. He goes in the court. Oh, hang on. I think that was a double movement. I don't know. I thought he had two goes at that. And he scored a try. Well, we'll have a look at the replay there. I thought he had two goes at that. Dubbo with numbers.
Let's have a look.
The ball around the 11 gets
it. They put it through their hands really well there, Dubbo.
That's
just that second line.
He goes in the court. Oh, hang on. I think that was a double movement.
I thought he promoted the ball, but anyway.
I think that was a double movement. I don't know. I thought he had to make it 23-17. With about 3 minutes to go, and that's really disheartening for Orange City. There's still a bit of time left yet, but it'll be an important restart. But Dubbo kept it through the hands there extremely well. They gave offloads to each other, inside offloads. Dubbo's still with a man in the sin bin as the halfback lines it up, and he's missed it. So City still have a chance. They need to get the ball off the kickoff here, Orange City. They need to put the extra effort in. As Duncan Young brings it up, there wouldn't be long to go here. Talk about a grandstand finish winner to go into the grand final next Saturday against Emus at Wade Park. Duncan Young starts. It's a fairly shadow. McHugh takes it up. City need the ball back. They fire it out to the centre of the field. They need the ball as they gave it back to Dubbo, and he puts it downfield, goes to Witters. What's he going to do with it here? It goes to Lamborghini. He needs some help here. Puts it downfield. Oh, it's gone straight to the Dubbo fullback, and he puts it downfield. It goes back to Thomas McKenzie. What's he going to do? He's going to go for a run. That's what he's going to do. And he, as long as Orange City maintain possession here and just edge it up. That's all they need to do is just edge it up. Dubbo, Lamborghini takes it up. Here they go, City. You've just got to edge it up. As Rakai Tahaki takes it up, they've maintained possession. What happens if they go wide here? Goes to Lamborghini, goes on to Witters. He goes inside. He's pretty quick. They need to get some players in. Oh, that was lucky. There's the City maintaining possession still here. They go wide. Lamborghini. Oh, that was hard tackle there. There's the ball. City still holding possession here. Lamborghini, what's he going to do here? City needs something here. They go forward, they're maintaining possession. All they've got to do is hold on to this and roll it up the field. There's a penalty to Orange City there. He was offside. What are they going to do here, City? They're having a bit of a think about it. Well, as they put it into the corner for a line out, as 15 on 15 now. Well,
City. Line out feed. About 10 metres out from the Dubbo line. Wouldn't be long to go. They win the line out, Orange City. They go down. They've got the ball. They've just got to keep possession here. Lamborghini with the ball. Tohaki takes it up. Duncan Young takes it up the middle. They've got to get some forwards there. They've got to maintain possession. Nell out to Lamborghini. Inside ball. Oh, that's strong defence by Dubbo. But City still maintaining the ball. It goes out. They run it. He goes, oh, he was nearly through that gap there. City still have the ball. Goes to Tremaine. Tremaine, oh, he's dropped the ball. He's knocked it on. Dubbo have possession. There's a knock on by Orange City. The referee looks at his whistle. Not yet. Knock on. That was a crucial knock on. One last scrum, I'd say. There wouldn't be much time left in this. The Roos 23, City 17. And again, we'd like to thank our sponsor of this live stream, Mal and Beck Cheney, Timber Transport. Thank you very much for your kind sponsorship of this live stream and all the other sponsors of Orange City. Not long to go. City need a scrum here. If they ever needed a scrum against the feed, it's one right here. 10 metres out. Dubbo put the ball in. Their scrum's rock solid. That's not going anywhere. City trying to move it. Dubbo. Oh, he's knocked it on. He's knocked it on. Wow. If you ever talk about an opportunity, here is an opportunity for Orange City. Well, how about that? They need to do something here, Orange City, because I can tell you it would be very close to full time. I would say this is the last play of the game. They're 10 out. They need a converted try, Orange City, to go on and meet Emus in a local derby grand final at Wade Park next Saturday. They get the scrum set. It's down. Referee not happy with it. He's called it up. He's called it up, talking to the front rowers again. He wants it packed again. Tremaine gets down. The other forwards follow him. This would have to be the last play of the day. Roos leading 23-17. Scrum sets. It's quiet in the grandstand. They know how important this. Tom Nell feeds it in. City, what are they going to do? Duncan Young. He's caught. He goes forward. City maintaining possession. That's the way they go. As Tremaine goes forward, he's been met heavily in defence. Rakai Tohaki takes it forward. That's great work. City holding the ball. It goes. He's going inside into the forwards. Probably the place to go. As City still maintain possession. City maintains possession. It's a close go. It's a penalty to Orange City. Penalty to Orange City. What are they going to do here? Well, there's only one thing they can do. He takes a tap. He goes forward. Oh, he's so close. Orange City are so close here. No, they're maintaining possession. Oh, they maintain. They've got to maintain possession here, Orange City. They're so close to the line. As they go forward, they need just to take their time and not panic here. Oh, that looked like the ball went down there. No, they've still got the ball, Orange City. What are they going to do? They've got to just play possession. They've got to take their time. They're so close. Orange City have the ball. They've just got to... Oh, they've scored a try, Orange City! They've got it! They've scored left of the post!
Well, that was unbelievable. The Dubbo 5-8, that's a great try to Orange City. 23-22, kick to come. This could put them into the grand final against Orange Emus next Saturday at Wade Park. What a try. Fantastic work by the forwards. They kept the ball. They kept on plugging away, but they're not there yet. There's an important kick to come. And you talk about pressure. This is what goal kickers, that's why they kick their veins of ice. Let's see how Duncan Young handles this one. I'm sure this will be full time as soon as this ball is kicked. And Orange City season, whether they continue on to the grand final, is all on Duncan Young's shoulders. He kicked one from here not long ago. Let's see how he goes. He's the referee telling Dubbo to go back. He moves into it. And he's kicked it. He's kicked it. Orange City are in the grand final. They play Emus. Dubbo dejected. Orange City win. Local derby grand final. What a game of football. And look at the celebrations. Orange City are so happy. This is fantastic news. Dubbo complaining to the ref, but too late, boys. She's all over. Orange City go to the grand final against Orange Emus at Wade Park. We have a local derby grand final, and who would have thought that Orange City would have made the grand final, and they have. So a big day next Saturday at Wade Park. I'd like to thank all the viewers. I'd like to thank all the sponsors, and Orange City once again have made it through to the grand final. I'd like to thank Cheney Transport, Timber Transport, Malinbeck. I'd like to thank all the sponsors. And what an action-packed day tomorrow, next Saturday will be down at Wade Park. Thank you, and over and out from Dubbo's Apex Oval. Great win, Orange City.
Sondell Mixtape.
I'm waiting for you. I'm alone and I wonder, trying not to lose my mind, but it doesn't matter, 'cause my feet